Today, we shall reflect on the life of Saint Severin of Noricum. Nothing definite is known about the antecedents of Saint Severin. He spent a part of his early life in the deserts of the East before opting out to preach the gospel in Noricum in Astura. When he first came to Astura, he met with harshness from the people. Having warned them about the punishment God had reserved for them, he repaired to Hainburg. His prophecy soon came to be true when the Huns invaded the city and destroyed its inhabitants. Because of the fulfillment of this prophecy and of his many charitable works, he became famous among them. Faviana, a city on the Danube, distressed by a famine, implored his assistance. In response, he began preaching penance to them, which resulted in much fruit. He so fervently implored a rich woman who had hoarded up more than she needed that she distributed much of her provisions among the poor. There he wrought numerous miracles, redeemed captives, healed the sick, relieved the oppressed, and averted many public calamities and brought peace and blessing wherever he went. Many urged him to be their bishop, but he withstood their importunities because he knew that the solitude he loved so dearly would attract more people to him than any episcopal dignity. He established a monastery at Biotro, Nepasau, and another at Faviana. He fasted until sunset and always walked barefoot. His cell was so low that the kings and princes of the barbarians who came to visit him could not stand aright in it. Severin had foretold his death long before he fell ill on the 15th of January 482. He passed away on the fourth day of his illness. When Odoacer repatriated the Romans, the monks transported Saint Severin's body to Luculanum near Naples. Later, his relics were enshrined in the Benedictine monastery bearing his name.